কৃপা সিন্ধু সুসংপূর্ণ সর্বসত্ত্ব উপকারক নিষ্পৃহ সর্বতঃ সিদ্ধ্যো সর্ববিদ্যা বিশারদ সর্ব সংশয় সংশ্চেতা অনলস গুরুরা শ্রীশীল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর উপাচ্য ইন দ্য নেম অফ হরি ভজন অ্যান্ড হরি কথা those who are misguiding common people, we common people are so foolish, we want to be cheated by them, that's why we are cheated. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, in the name of Harikatha Harivadan, those who are misguiding common people, we common people are so foolish, we want to be cheated by them, that's why automatically we are cheated, we cannot get any actual thing. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, Bhakti Vinod Dhara will stay forever. Actually, we will have to keep Bhakti Vinod Dhara flowing. We will have to keep Bhakti Vinod Dhara flowing through our writing and speech. That is the main duty. That is our main duty. We are always trying to keep Bhakti Vinod Dhara flowing. That is our main duty, main seva. And all other things can be done automatically. You need not play your head over that. Sometime Prabhupada telling, the whole world is inundated by flood. So what is the problem with you? You come to me and listen Chaitanya Charitamrita, nothing lost. If Srimad Bhagavatam is there, if Chaitanya Charitamrita is there, we have all property, nothing lost. So why you are feeling tension? That is the main seva, Bani Seva. Bani Seva is the main seva. Sometime Prabhupada speaking to execute the order of a pure Vaishnava, Paramahansa Vaishnava, I am ready to go to hell with contact. I can sign on contact paper, bond paper. I like to go to hell to implement, to execute the order of Paramahansa Vaishnava. I am ready to go to hell with a nice contact. I don't feel sorry for them. Nobody can understand the mood of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. Somebody misunderstand him. His very false ego is there with Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Somebody think he want to show his own power this way. Many people passing different kind of remark. But actually, yesterday I already explained what do you mean by Trinadapi? How I can understand that one sadhu is actually Paramahansa Trinadapi? How to understand? You can find 26 qualities of Vaishnava recorded. I am written, but out of that, Krishnaika Saran is the pivoted quality, center point. Krishnaika Saran is the pivoted quality, I mean center point of all qualities. All the qualities centering this Krishnaika Saran, they are staying. If Krishnaika Saran is not there, if Krishnaika Saran, this quality is off, then all other quality have got no meaning, useless. Be careful. Yesterday, I was speaking one soul. I was discussing, you can remember, what slope?
Was it the Vayu Purana slope?
No. Yasu Devi Parabhakti Yatha Devi Tatha Guru Tasish Etashita Eti Katitahi Artha Prakasanti Mahatmana. Yesterday I was discussing this point. First of all, you must remember, if you hear so many Harikatha from Gurudev, if you are here, okay. If you are hearing so many Harikatha, but if you are not doing any seva practically, then those Harikatha have no result in your life. Like Upamannu, you know, Upamannu from Upanishad, I already told. Gurudev giving him order, you go to forest and with the cows, you go there. After some time, you can come back. Upamannu one history. Many big in Upanishad, very nice. How Upamannu got Dibya Gyan? How Upamannu got Dibya Gyan? That is a practical example. All our Guru Bhargava. Parampriya Bhakti Pamapuri Goswami Maharaj, Parampriya Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Vedanta, Bhakti Madhava Goswami Maharaj. They are doing Guru Seva, after that they are getting power. Without Guru Seva, they are not getting any power. If you are hearing so many Harikatha from Gurudev, but still you cannot get power. If you are not interested to do any seva, through seva you can get knowledge. That is the main thing. And the sloka with which I started, Kripa Sindhu Susangpurno Sarva Sattu Pukarakaha. Kripa Sindhu is a pool of mercy, I mean ocean, unending ocean. Kripa Sindhu Susangpurno Sarva Sattu Pukarakaha. Susangpurno, my Guru Pad Padma, I mean Paramahansa Gurudev, never feel any dissatisfaction in heart. Paramahansa Guru, Paramahansa Vaishnava never feel any kind of dissatisfaction. There is no deficiency. They are complete tattva. Krishna is complete. And Guru Vaishnava is also thing. They never feel any kind of dissatisfaction. Main thing. Kripa Sindhu Susangpurno Sarva Sattva Pukarakaha. All jivatma in this infinity world, they are always compassionate for them, towards them. Always. Anything they are doing, anything they are speaking, their any activity, all for the good of us. Always. They are trying to give some benefit, I mean spiritual benefit. Otherwise not. Now Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, people they are confused automatically. How to understand who is Vaishnava, who is not? Perfect Vaishnava, who is perfect Vaishnava, who is not? How to understand? Because we all are in same Vaishnava uniform, with tilak, mala, chanting, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. All of us doing chikirtan, chanting, going to Dhamma for parikram, taking prasadam, doing ekadasi fasting, everything we are doing. Same, everybody. It is common factor. As if it is a common factor for all. Everybody doing. One sannyasi, you are brahmachari, he is grihastha, everybody. But how I can understand? What is the scientific procedure through which I can understand he is not at all Vaishnava, he is a demon? Because you know, Ravana, he also took sannyas vesh to abduct. Before abducting Sita Devi, Ravana also took the base of sannyasis. Ravana also took the base of sannyasis. So what it concerned to us? Everybody, you can also take sannyas. I can also take sannyas. He can. Everybody is entitled. Because who is going to stop you? Nobody. So what is the procedure through which I can 100% can understand that he is a demon in the guise of devotee? How to understand? Srila Bhakti, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur speaking. If you see, they are always against pure Vaishnava. Those pure Vaishnava, they have some siddhanta, special activities. Those who are demonic character, they are always against them. You can follow them, you can stay there, you can say they are criticizing pure Vaishnava, they are going against. Yeah. Now, today, I like to illustrate some as example in front of you, so that you can understand everything. Paramahansa Vaishnava, actually, all our Guru Varga, they are actually all Paramahansa, our Guru Varga. Most of them, they are all Guru Varga. But Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati also Paramahansa. But still, they come down to second level, I mean, Madhyam Adhikari, forcefully, to preach. Because on Paramahansa, he is not in a position to preach. Yesterday I was discussing this point. Haridas Thakur is number one preacher in the world. You know? Sanatan Goswami Pad is number one preacher in the world. Rupa Goswami Pad is number one preacher in the world. Jiva Goswami Pad number one. But externally, we don't see they are moving here and there. That's why from Bhai Purana I wanted to establish this point that their activities, their siddhanta, their writing, their bhava, still we are getting inspiration from them. Jiva Goswami Pad gone, Rupa Goswami Pad gone, Jiva Goswami, every, all Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, but still we are getting inspiration from them. That is why yesterday I was bound to discuss this point. Those Vaishnava, those who are taking leave from this material world, but still they are giving some influence. They are putting some influence on us to go ahead with a positive mood of bhakti, not negative mood. They are actually pure Vaishnava, actually. So you see, to understand who is Vaishnava, who is not, you will have to stay and minutely will have to follow that they are always criticizing pure Vaishnava, what they are against pure Vaishnava, their activities, their anything they sit down, that they are all against. They are always against them. Then you can understand they are not at all Vaishnava. Maybe they are in the base of sannyas or brahmachari, maybe. That's not it. Big factor. That's not a big factor. So, Kripa Sindhu Susangpurno. Susangpurno means in Sanskrit, if you learn Sanskrit, you can understand. Sampurno means complete. Sampurno means complete. But Susangpurno means very nicely complete. Very nicely. Susangpurno, very nice. Susangpurno, sarva sattva pakarakaha. In this infinity world, there is infinity jivatma. Can you count jivatma? Even though, even Bhagavatam it is written, avatara of Sri Krishna, you cannot count. Infinity avatara. Avatara hi asankhyata. You cannot count. Because in infinity world, infinity Brahmanda there, infinity Brahmanda, I don't know where Bhaktivelo Tirtha Goswami Maharaj is now gone. I cannot speak. In any Brahmanda, he is now going to manifest another nice Leela. Because pure Vaishnava, their Leela is also Nitya. Nitya Siddha and Sadhan Siddha. Jodha Nitya Siddha, their Leela is also eternal. Bhakti Siddhanta, his Leela is also eternal. Maybe he is doing some other Leela in another Brahmanda, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. How we can understand that really Leela is eternal?
In they keep the form or they change?
Huh?
They keep their form, this form?
Actually, Bhakti Vinod Thakur is same, Paramahansa Keshava Goswami Maharaj is giving answer, very nice. Keshava Goswami Maharaj speaking, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, hear me, very perfectly. Bhakti Vinod Thakur is the appearance, is Nitya. How Nitya? How you say? Nitya is Gauranga Parsha. But suppose now in this Brahmanda he is now 45 years age. And after that we see his growing age. Like Krishna. Krishna childhood Leela in some Brahmanda is now just Krishna took born. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving argument to Sanatana. Just now speaking, now Krishna taking birth in one Brahmanda. Now Krishna is stealing yoga, in one Brahmanda. So this way, chain-wise Brahmanda, this Leela become Nitya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving an argument. Same thing with Nitya Siddha Parsha. Like Srinivas Acharya, Narottama Thakur, Ramchandra Kaviraj, same. They are also coming and going with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This way they are manifesting Leela. Nitya Siddha Parsha. Those who are Sadhan Siddha, from today onward, if they, today now they live, now suppose one pure Vaishnav now living body. Now he enter into Nitya Leela. From today onward he can manifest this kind of. Follow, you see. So this way, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, any form, maybe at the age of 45 years, it is also Nitya. Bhakti Vinod Thakur manifesting 78 years old, is also Nitya in mind. Now, somebody putting question, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Prabhupada, actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, like clockwise. Now somebody putting question, Maharaj, we already see Bhakti Puri Goswami living his body. The body is there with us. How to understand his Nitya? Keshav Goswami Maharaj giving answer very nicely. Keshav Goswami Maharaj speaking, actually, you already know the point. When Krishna living body, there is so many fighting among different parties. Come on, man, we see Krishna lying, Krishna's body we see. In different Purans, Skanda Puran you can find, here, there, maybe. How to tally? That's why our Guru Bhargava giving us warning that you must approach a pure Vaishnava to reconcile. Because if there is any doubt regarding Siddhanta, anything, Dhamma, Nama, Siddhanta, then you are not going to come out successful in your life. Sangsayatma Vinashvati. So now how to understand this big problem? Srila Keshav Goswami Maharaj speaking. Keshav Goswami Maharaj speaking. Just like Krishna Leela, we see Krishna in Bhagavata. Because Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam Prema Pumartha Mahanava Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhura Matam Idam Tatradharana. We are less interested about any Siddhanta and Vichar from anywhere. Only we want to give honor to Bhagavat Siddhanta because it is approved by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now point is that in Bhagavatam we find when Krishna going away from this material world, we find already some chariot coming and Krishna climbed this chariot and automatically those indifferent because seven lokas up. Bhur Bhuva Swa Maho Yano Tapo Satya. Krishna climbing up. This chariot going up. And different loka, different they have their head. They are all full troops. They are doing arati of Krishna. Different loka. Mahaloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka, Sataloka, they are doing arati. Krishna going with the same body. But Skanda Purana had a different place we find Krishna leave his body. Now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving argument, I mean giving perfect Siddhanta to Sanatan. Sanatan, be careful. When Krishna living body, when all Gopikas are abducted by that will on low caste man, all illusion done by Jogumaya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself giving argument. Be careful. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving argument to Sanatan. Sanatan, this is perfect Siddhanta. You see, when Krishna leave his body, everybody saying Krishna's body is there. When Gopikas are abducted, how to understand, how to reconcile? Because different kind of question and contradiction coming. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is all done by Jogamaya. Those who are demonic character, those who are foolish, Krishna like to cheat them. That's why Jogamaya and Mahamaya are engaged. Mahamaya engaged for what purpose? This is Sisti Siti Palaya Sadhana Sakti Reka Chayeva Jasya Bhumanani Vibharti Durga. Very nice. I was explaining this sloka long days ago in Seva Kunj. Very nicely. Long days ago. So this way you see, we are always cheated. If we have the chance to meet a pure Vaishnava, pure Shuddha Vaishnava, then we can cut all our Siddhanta. That is the sloka I started with. Sarva Sansaya Sanscheta. Otherwise, is no more. Every step, we are going to meet problems. Because without problem, we cannot think bhajan life. Bhajan life is full of problem. Bhajan life is full of problem. Bhajan life always billions of throne is there. In every step put a throne going inside your leg. So you cannot expect bhajan life free of any tension and problem, nothing. But still have to reconcile everything to test me. Krishna wants to test me. That is the actual procedure. So now you follow. Gopikas are abducted, whereas Arjun is already there. Krishna giving responsibility to Arjun. You will have to take responsibility. You will have to guide all Gopikas and take them there. And the midway, one bill or low caste people, tribals, they are fighting with Arjun. Arjun is defeated. Strong. Arjun is never defeated. But now Arjun defeated. Arjun crying. I don't know how I am defeated. Is it possible? Not possible. But Arjun is defeated. After that, when all Krishna gone, then Arjun coming back to Indraprastha, meeting Yudhishthira Maharaj, and now crying. Now speaking, Gita lecture, all Gita pravachan done by Krishna, and Arjun hearing. After that, when Gita is over, Krishna, Arjun, Krishna asking, all your doubts gone? Are you free from any tension on, contradiction? Free? Well, I am free. But that Arjun, when Gita Prabhupada was there, Kurukshetra, itself in Kurukshetra battlefield, long years ago. Now after long time, when Krishna gone, now he is coming back from Dwarka to meet Yudhishthir Maharaj, now crying, now saying that Krishna was there with me. I heard so many things from Krishna. But now today, my knowledge is perfect. I mean, in ripe form. I heard everything. Krishna giving me advice, everything. But that was not perfect. That was not perfect for me. I couldn't realize it 100% that time. When Krishna gone, now I feel everything is flourish. All knowledge is now manifested. Now I feel. I thought I am a most powerful man in the world. Now today I think I was fighting everything by the power of Krishna. Arjun speaking. I thought it was my personal power. Krishna thought, why I am speaking this? To cut false ego inside me. When the Brahman came in Dwarka, or one child taking birth and instantly dying. 6-8 boys taking birth and going out. Then that Brahman coming and complaining in front of Dwarka gate, king's house. But that king is not pious, I think. That's why I'm meeting this problem. Why my child, every time my wife giving birth, and every time dying? Then Arjun speaking, okay, next time I am going to protect you. Nobody can take. Your child, I am going to protect. But Arjun with commitment, if I fail to save your boy, child, then I am going to enter into fire. But Arjun was not successful. Arjun with arrow, Arjun making such a construction so that even a small piece, a dust particle cannot go out. But still the Jivatma gone. Arjun couldn't protect. Then he was about to jump into fire. Krishna says, stop my friend. Why? My commitment was there. I can. Then Krishna speaking, stop now. I can take you one place. You can understand everything, the mystery. This way, what I mean to say, we will have to cut all your false ego, inside. Everything done by Krishna. So you see, Gopikas were abducted, Krishna living body, everything done by Yoga Maya. And in the material world, those material people suffering, those are done by Mahamaya. Now point is that, Pandya Keshav Goswami Maharaj giving same example. In Skanda Puran you can find Krishna leave his body, his navel portion, this portion, was thrown into water, that is coming, flowing, and that came here in Mahanadi, there, that is called Mahanadi, Jagannath Nilmadham. This confusion. Actually, Krishna, this way, Paramahansa Kesava Goswami was speaking, when our Guru Varga living body in front of us, so like snake in one ear living is all outside covering. It is just like snake. When I was doing in bhajan in Gokula forest, I saw morning time he come out of heart, bhajan kuchir, I see one snake is there. Very careful, I see, oh, it's not snack. It's just a covering, I mean screen, chain. It is just like, Paramahansa Kesava Goswami is giving argument, Bhaktivinoda Thakur leaving his body in front of us, it is done by Yoga Maya, but still, you should not think that body is not transcendental. You should not think that. It is also there. Because from Upanishad we know Purnasya Purnam Adayo Purnam Eva Avashishyate. In material world we have this kind of conception. If some thing is taken from this place, how this thing we can expect that thing to be there again? How? If I take your pen away from this place, how is it possible that pen is also there? Not possible. But in transcendental world, there is possible. There is possible. Kesava Goswami is giving this argument. So this way, you see, Vaishnava Tattva, now you understand Vaishnava Tattva is very so fine and excellent. Now I like to discuss some Siddhanta. So Kipa Sindhu Susangpurna Sarva Sattva Pukarakaha Nispriho. You cannot expect any kind of desire, even smell of desire, inside the heart of a pure Vaishnava. Regarding seva is different thing. I like to do seva. This is different thing. So you see, each and every point you should follow. Kipa Sindhu Susangpurna Sarva Sattva Pukarakaha Nispriho. There is no desire. I mean no smell of any desire. Nispiyo sarvatoho siddhyo. He is always siddhyo. Siddho means he can do anything. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada can do anything he like. But he never exhibit that kind of power in front of public. All siddhi is there. All siddhi coming and touching the lotus feet of Vaishnava. Can you accept me? Can you give me a chance to serve you? But Vaishnava say, no time, no seva. No. All siddhi coming. Mukti swayam mukulitanjali sevate asmyano dharmartha kama gatayo samayo pratiksha. Mukti coming in front. Mukti coming in front of the body. Can you accept me? You go. I don't need mukti. Why? Because as per Vaishnava Siddhanta, muktir hitya anyatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. Muktir hitva anyatha rupam. We cannot expect any kind of, change of our inside atma. It is mukti, actually those who are mayavadi, those who are brahmavadi, brahma. They like to get submerged with brahma, brahmalin. It is highly, rejected by Vaishnava. Vaishnava never want mukti. Because their mukti is like a suicidal squad. Suicidal squad, you know? Those who are doing suicidal squad, they keep on bomb inside and they jump there. They like to kill themselves. They like to destroy the target with which he came. Follow. It is one kind of suicidal squad. Suicide means I like to kill myself. But Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada speaking, we cannot expect that kind of thing. The object we want to test, the object we want to, who is going to test? Three things, you know. The testing this matter of testing. Testing, I like to test. So testing is a matter. And what thing you like to test? That is, what thing? And who is going to test? Three things. So Krishna is there, Jivatma is there, and Bhakti is there. Because Bhakti is always giving nourishment to us. Without Bhakti, we don't like to live. Don't follow. How we are living? How we are getting enjoyment? Bhakti Devi giving us Bhakti. Bhakti Devi actually giving nourishment. Giving. That's why you are enjoying. So you see? So Bhakti and Krishna, Bhakti means procedure, activities. And who is doing Bhakti to whom? These three is in, should be in one planet, same planet. It should be in same planet. Krishna, who is doing Bhakti to Krishna, and the Bhakti, the object, should be in same planet. If there is up down, then there is problem. Follow. Don't follow. There should be in one problem. Bhakti means activities. Bhakti is the natural function of your soul. Bhakti is the natural function of your soul. Bhakti means Bhakti is staying inside the heart of a devotee. The activities expressed by the devotee is called Bhakti. Follow. So Bhakti, who is expressing Bhakti, who is showing Bhakti, whom to serve, the servant whom to serve and the service should be in same planet. If there is any up down, then there is problem. Follow, don't follow.
What do you mean same planet?
Same platform.
Plane.
Same plane. Otherwise there is problem. So now point is there. Bhakti is the natural function of your show. So those who are doing suicidal squat, they are interested. They like to go and submerge with Brahma. But that is not our target. Brahma Sajujya and Vigraha Sajujya. I mean, Brahma Sajujya one. And you know Shishupal, they get submerged with Krishna in front of all sages and all devotees. Shishupal Atma, when Krishna cut with wheel the thorn of Shishupal, then the Atma like light going gradually and coming unto the lotus feet of Krishna and submerge in front of all, everybody. That is not Brahma Sajujya. That is called Vigraha Sajujya. I mean, itself in Krishna's body. Two kinds of Sajujya. Four kinds of, you know, Salokya, Sajujya, Shasti, Samipya, you know everything. So those who are pure Vaishnav, they are less interested about that. But those who are not established in pure bhakti, always they can have some kind of desire. But still, if they are worshipping Krishna, showing bhakti to Krishna, today or tomorrow they can also come. Or in Gauriya Siddhanta, I can discuss this point sometime. Annavilasita sunyam jnana karmadi anavritam anukillena krishnanusuranam. That point I can show you. How finely you can explain. Otherwise you can understand. But you see, you can have desire. But still if you do bhakti, I mean only and only if you like to worship Krishna, then there is no problem. Today or tomorrow you can come. If you are serving Shuddha Vaishnav, getting association of Shuddha Vaishnav, you like to worship only Krishna, no all demigods, nothing to get any facility. then today or tomorrow you are also going to get this facility. Otherwise not. So this is the situation. You must understand far. Now pure Vaishnava, they can reserve the right of not being exposed in front of you. Those who are pure Vaishnava reserve the right of not being exposed to your sense organ. Krishna, same thing. Krishna, the Supreme Lord, can reserve the right of not being exposed to your sense organ. Same thing is applicable in the case of pure Vaishnava. Be careful. Otherwise, big problem. Almost tata I am setting. I mean, giving example so that you cannot make any mistake in future. Now, Srila Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj is a pure Vaishnava. You agree? Everybody agree. They agree or don't agree, that doesn't matter. It's pure Vaishnava. But still, some contradiction can be there among some devotees. They are passing different kind of remarks. You already know. In Chandigarh, here, there, or Bhatinda, I speak Siddhanta. One or two, three Siddhanta I can speak in front of you, so that you can understand that what is the heart of Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, and is there any different? Is there any different with Bhakti? Different in opinion among Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami and me? You can understand this point, the main point. First of all, someday I pass remark there, I mean Siddhanta, that Bindadevi, if we say mother, then Rasa Tattva you cannot get. That's big problem. I told the simple Siddhanta. I don't know why even a 5 years child, I mean boy, can understand this point. They can understand this point. Some devotees, they going against me. Still today they are fighting, they want to prove I am against Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami. I am laughing. Okay, nice. Let them speak so. They are speaking, Maharaj, neighbors, stop us to sing this song. Namore, namore, maya, namanarayan. They are speaking. I told them, why Maharaj not giving any remark on it? Because Maharaj knowing you have no entry into Rasa Tattva. Many Guru Varga. Even Parampuja Keshav Goswami Maharaj, in morning time Kirtan, Arati Kirtan, by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bale Gora Gada Dhare Arati Ne. After that, Kishoro Kishori, Kalpotaru Tale, Ratna Singhasana Pari. Now material people, there is all young. Material people, they have no idea. They say, oh, young girls and Krishna is there. What kind of Leela is? Huh? They can think, the Keshav Goswami Maharaj, they change. Write new Kirtan. So many devotees say, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, not approve this Kirtan. You are foolish. I say, you are foolish. You don't know. Maharaj approved this Kirtan. But still, Maharaj like to keep standard for common people. That's why. So now I give argument. They are coming in front of me. They are putting slogan. Why you speak that? I say, excuse me. I give argument. I like to give argument. First of all, Maharaj not stopping you to speak this song because Maharaj think you have no entry into Rasa Tattva. At least, if you can sing this way, it's also good. Bindadevi, you can get some kippa. And another kirtan, in Radha Kijog, Radha Krishna Kunjo Seva. Another kirtan, small kirtan is there. Tulasi Krishna Priyasi. This is Raj Siddhanta. Tulasi Krishna based there, you can see one point. There I like to get entry into Vilas Kunja. Then our Samapar Guru Bhagya so stay. Hey, what you are speaking? You like to get entry into Vilas Kunja? How dare you speak like that? Understand? That doesn't mean Maharaj approved that second kirtan. I mean, you speak, go on speaking Radharani Mother, Bindadevi Mother, Lolita Mother, then how you can? Father and Mother, we have no right to think anything about Father and Mother. That's why Prabhupada told one thing. One big scholar, Pandit is there, you know, Kalidas. Excellent! Big scholar. Sanskrit literature, you know, Kalidas Pandit. He is writing so many writing, even in MA class, MA. You are bound to read Kalidas. Kumar Sambhav, Meghdoot, Kumar Sambhav, Shakuntalam, so many things. But Prabhupada speaking, by the mercy of Saraswati, by the mercy of Saraswati, material Saraswati. Saraswati, two kind of Saraswati. One is Vaikuntha Saraswati, one is material Saraswati. By the mercy of material Saraswati, he expressed super, mane, excellency. Oh. You know, now he is writing everything. You see, but Prabhupada speaking, what kind of fool is this? But why? But whenever he writing his book, first of all, Bande Pitaro Gauri Sankaro, Shankar and Parvati, Father and Mother, you know. Shankar Parvati, who is? Shankar is my father. Parvati mother. Actually, your mother is not actual mother. My mother is not actual mother. All mother, I mean mother Tatta, coming from Parvati. Your mother, his mother, his mother, all mother. You go, you can find, originally you can find, Parvati is the original Tatta, I mean mother Tatta in this material world. Parvati is mother. Nobody man. Follow my point. And Shankar is father. And Shivalinga, I can explain this point from Brahma Sangita. Not now. It can make hodgepodge siddhanta. So now I have speciality. Shivalinga. What do you mean by Shivalinga? How we okay. From Brahma Sangita I can explain this point. So now you say, Shankar is father, mother Parvati mother. You have no right to see and discuss any secret lila of Shankar or Parvati. Can you? Not possible. It is common sense. But before writing any book, I mean books compiled by Kalidas, first of all is Bande Pitaro Gauri Shankar. After that, after some pages, he is narrating all the secret lila of Gauri and Shankar. Popat laughing. How is that possible? He is just doing bandana father mother. Now he is discussing secret lila of father mother. Foolish Pandit. That example I give. Then Parampujivad, Bhaktivallabh Chaturvedi, very, very clever. At least you are doing Kirtan of Bindadevi, doing Parikram. But you see, Maharaj, knowing inside heart, and if father, mother, if I say Bindadevi mother, how is possible I can get entry into Bindadevi? Because Bindadevi is the sole authority. Gangeya champeya tarita binindi rati pravaho snapitatma bin banduka bandu rutiti pavaso gunde namaste. You can go through this verse, you can find Bindadevi giving us entry into then how I can... Still they are not ready to accept. Still today, 7 years gone, they are fighting. Someday, from Bhajan Rahasya, I was... from Bhagavatam, I was just... I told, as per Bhajan Rahasya, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing so many things. Backside Bhajan Rahasya, there is so many kirtan, jama kirtan. But first of all, you must understand how to go ahead in bhajan. That is why Bhaktivinoda Thakur compiled this Bhajan Rahasya. Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur? I can discuss in thorough discuss after some time, after some days, not now. Step by step, how to get entry, Bhajan Rahasya you can. Now, after that, you can find there is jama kirtan. Now our Guru Varga, they are not foolish. They know we have no entry into jama kirtan. Jama kirtan is a top secret matter. Prathamam namno sabane tadudaya yogyata bhavati. First of all, before hearing pure name, you must develop quality. Otherwise, you cannot hear pure name. You cannot utter pure name. Gurudev, while giving you a name, follow me, what I say. At the time and initiation, Gurudev giving me pure Harinam. Pure. I mean, Gurudev already giving Krishna to me. Don't follow. Jiva Goswami was speaking. Why Gurudev giving you initiation, Harinam, Harinam Diksha, Gurudev speaking, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. I mean, Radha Govinda is there with that transcendental sound. That means at the time of initiation, Guru Maharaj wanted to give Krishna to me, Radha Krishna to me. No doubt. But I was just unfit to accept that transcendental sound vibration. Now what to do? Through practice, I can develop that quality. Diksha mean Kam Gayatri, Brahma Gayatri, Kam Gayatri mean Kam Dev itself. Because as per mantra, you know what is Kam Gayatri, that is Krishna in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Mantra Devata is equal to mantra. Mantra Devata is equal to mantra. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, you see, in Kama Gayatri, 24 and a half akshar, I mean syllabi. Each have got different kind of meaning. So there you see, Krishna, Kama Gayatri and Krishna all same. Kama Gayatri mantra is equal to Krishna. Not less than equal to, not greater than equal to. In mathematics we find. Less than equal to, greater than equal. Not that. Exact equal to. Kam Gayatri is equal to Krishna. But still, when I got mantra, I couldn't understand it. Oh, this is Kam Gayatri means Krishna himself? Vishwanath Chakravarti was in confusion about this point. And Kam Gayatri mantra, Vrindavandas Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami explaining. Then Krishnadas Kaviraj, Vishwanath Chakravarti fasting in at the bank of Radha Kunda. I am not going to take any water, prasadam, nothing. Unless I can understand this point. How is that possible? Then Radharani came in dream. Stop your fasting. Get up. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking rightly. Is Kasturi Manjari, Priyanarma Sakhi. Kasturi Manjari is speaking rightly. Barnabhi Gamat, one special book compiled thousands of years back. As per that book, there is half word syllabi. This way, oh really? Then I get up, stop fasting and starting dancing. Because Vasana Chakravarti is speaking, until and unless I can understand this mantra, how I can meet with the mantra devata? Foolish people, they don't understand. Guru Maharaj giving me mantra. If I cannot meet mantra devata, what is the success in my life? Don't follow me. If I am successful, then surely I, through mantra, Kam Gayatri, I can see mantra devata. All his being. Kam Gayatri. Otherwise, I am not seen. I am not successful. Follow. Big point. So what I wanted to explain? Main point? You forget it. Eh? Sarvato siddhutu adhudachi, sarvatoha siddhya, sarvavidya visarada. Now I wanted to discuss this point that Kalidas narrating this Leela. Prabhupada speaking, how is that possible? Father and mother. So this way I explain everything. That at the time of Kartik Vrata, some of your Godbada, they are coming with save cheek. They are saving their beard. Srila Bhaktivallabha Thakura Maharaj not passing any Rima. That doesn't mean it is approved by Bhaktivallabha Thakura. Follow me. Maharaj not speaking anything. That doesn't mean Maharaj approving. You can come. Still they are fighting. Still they are fighting. What to do? I told them Yamakitta is a very excellent thing. I am Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj, some of our Guru Varga, they in front of them. They give order. Ei lila karo ar, ei lila chinto ar karo sankirtan. This point is very vital. Ei lila chinto ar karo sankirtan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, last point. This is vital point. You must do sankirtan first. First of all, I told. Prathamam namno savane tadudaya yogyata bhavati. A nam, before hearing Harinam, you must develop quality to hear pure Harinam. And after that, you can have the chance to utter pure Harinam, not before that. Follow my point, one by one, very critical Siddhanta. Very critical Siddhanta. Dandavad, Dandavad. Very critical Siddhanta. They are the disciple of Bhaktivallabha Thakura, they are my father. I promise in front of you. They are all my father and mother. I don't think otherwise. For the past 3-4 days, I am discussing about the glories of Bhaktivallabha Thakura Goswami Maharaj. Why people misunderstand him? What is the secrecy of his Siddhanta? That I am 3-4 days, I am, at least. All glorious Siddhanta, Guru, Guru Tattva, Vaishnav Tattva, how to reconcile? Because if you have any doubt in your life, then you will have to take birth again. If you leave your body with doubt, Vaishnava, Dham, Nam, Vaishnava Tattva, Nam, Dham, Lila, Parikar, Vaishishto, any. If you have slightest doubt in your life, while you are leaving your body, then you will have to come and take birth again. Otherwise you cannot get Siddhi. So you know, you follow my point? Mantra Devata, Guru Maharaj giving me mantra. Again I like to go back, long ago, 80 years back, one incident happened in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. To explain this point, some small devotees, I mean our Guru Varga, they are small devotees. They are discussing among themselves under a tree in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, long ago, 80 years back maybe. There, what happens, you see? Some devotees, they are discussing among them, Prabhupada giving us Harinam. Harinam. The Prabhupada speaking, Harinam means Hari himself. But why we cannot understand it? They are discussing among themselves. Some young devotees, small. How we cannot understand? How is that possible? Then one senior devotee, Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavat Goswami Maharaj, he was passing to that place. What discussion going on? What discussion? No, actually, we cannot understand. The Harinam and Hari same. So Prabhupada giving us Harinam. So Harinam means why we cannot understand Hari still today? What is the reason behind it? Because Prabhupada is Prabhupada Nitya Siddha Parshad. Prabhupada giving us Harinam means Hari himself. Why we cannot understand? Then Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavat Goswami Maharaj giving one nice example. Very excellent example. Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavat Goswami Maharaj speaking, you know my you know, sometime it happens so, some small boy is there, 5 years old or 3-4 years old, father and mother gone from this material world, leaving that boy, leaving that boy, father gone, mother gone, but nobody is there, huh? Nobody is there to control that boy. But that father and mother leave huge property. A father leaving huge property, big property. But who can control that property? But that boy is 4 years now, right now. Then Maharaj giving example, father before leaving body, giving responsibility to one company. Suppose Talbot company, one company is there in Calcutta. They are doing this business. Anybody like to give all responsibility or all property with that board, they take some salary, I mean money, and they take all responsibility, control that property. Suppose father leaving big, huge amount of property, and that property responsibility given with the Talbot company. Talbot company taking control over that property, and as and when that boy grow up and get 18 years of age, then Talbot company coming and hand over the property, and you are now senior citizen. It is a condition written in paper. So today, now we like to hand over all property to you because you are a senior citizen now. So Maharaj giving example, Prabhupada already give big property to you, but you cannot realize because you are child. If somebody giving you lodging and biscuit, oh, you can take biscuit. If somebody giving 1,000, 2,000 rupees note, what they can do? Is that because child? They like to take biscuit and lodging. That's why Maharaj giving example, Prabhupada giving the property with you, it is there with you. But you cannot realize as and when you grow up and get the quality of senior citizenship. I mean, when you grow up, your realization can grow up to that level. You can feel, oh my God, Prabhupada giving up, already give Radha Krishna to me. All pure Vaishnavas, when they are speaking Harikatha, when they are speaking Harinam, when they are giving a mantra, that mantra is transcendental, and it is your duty to do it, chant it perfectly, and in this very life, you will have to meet Mantra Devata. Panchatatra, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Bhavani, you will have to meet Panchatatra. Kam Gayatri you are doing, you will have to meet Kam Gayatri. While you do Brahma Gayatri, you will have to feel Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, molten gold. Where? In Surya Mandal, sun god there? Surya Mandal, you understand? Sun, yes. There you can find sunlight and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, molten gold. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu here standing, almost. This is the excellent dhyan. Then you know, meditation. While you are doing Brahma Gayatri, you will have to think this thing. If you are a Gaudiya devotee. First of all, you will have to chant Gayatri. Brahma Gayatri will have to concentrate on this Surya Mandal. Sun God is there, all most powerful rays are coming, and you can meditate. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there inside the sun god. Molten gold. Oh, so powerful. Then your mantra is perfect. Follow. So each and every month, you have to meet that mantra devata. Otherwise, your bhajan is not perfect.
Can you explain, so Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is doing this nyas, chintan, there are some steps.
I can explain this point other time, because now I can discuss 100%. Be sure, very secretly I can go and discuss. Let Tidambi Maharaj come, he's very interested. Now point is that, I give this argument, Jam Kirtan is 100%, we must do. Because we are in Gauriya Bhajan. In Gauriya Bhajan, it is our last target. We must do Jam Kirtan. But you cannot understand the meaning of Jam Kirtan. You cannot feel anything. Because last instruction given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Eilila Chinto Ar Kore Sankirtan. Vital Siddhanta, you cannot cut. Eilila Chinto. Eilila. Now point is that which is beyond comprehension. Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking Eilila Chinto? You will have to think. But still another Siddhanta, it is beyond our comprehension. How I can think? Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking? Follow my point. One point is that it is beyond comprehension, inconceivable. If we can think, then it is surely a material thing. Then why Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving this instruction? Eilila Chinto Ar Karo Sankirtan. Vital point. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving you instruction, Eilila Chinto Ar Karo Sankirtan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur advising you, okay, first of all, under the guidance of very excellent Paramahamsa Gurudev, Eilila, this Lila you can think, but provided if you are doing Sankirtan. Provided you are doing Sankirtan. Shaddo Sadhan Tattva Jekiji Shakal Nama Sankirtan Se Paibe Shakal. Everything you can. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving advice, final advice to Sanatana Goswami. You Shaddo Sadhan Tattva anything. Shaddo our the goal to be attained it. Shaddo and Sadhan Tattva. All. Jekuju Shakal, Nama Sankirtan, to be pious. Through Nama Sankirtan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can give. So now you follow? What is the vital point? Nobody likes to project this point. They like to cut this point and throw. This vital point. So, Ilila, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving you advice, okay. Under the guidance of a pure, excellent, pure Paramahamsa Gurudev, you can think about, you can hear and think about this Leela, provided you are doing Sankirtan. If you are not doing Sankirtan, then you are going to fall down. Be careful. Sankirtan, now point is the, what do you mean by Sankirtan? Sankirtan mean that I like to satisfy Sankirtan Pita, Sankirtanik Pitaro. Pitaro means Dubachan, Gaurnitai, Gaurnitai. Anyway. Sankirtan Pita, father of Sankirtan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I like to satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu through my Kirtan. That is called Sankirtan. Not Kirtan. Be careful. I am not speaking Kirtan. I am speaking Sankirtan. Some material people can do Kirtan in different way. But when I speak Sankirtan, then it is perfect Kirtan. Transcendental sound vibration coming. I am now in a position to satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu the Sankirtan Pita 100%. That is called Sankirtan. I am doing Sankirtan by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, not satisfied. What kind of Sankirtan you are doing? Foolish. No Sankirtan. Follow my point. Then you can, 100% you go on chanting Jama Kirtan, 100% I can advise you. No restriction I can put, I promise you. Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami also wanted to speak the same Siddhanta like me. But whom to speak? Whom to speak if there is any right personality who can understand even a little thing? Then I can speak. Sometimes Prabhupada used to express grief. Whom to speak this Tata Siddhanta? Whom to speak? Where to speak? Prabhupada speaking. Bhakti Siddhanta Swami. Whom to speak? Where to speak? I don't find even a single place where I can speak all the secrets. That is why I came in this on this material plan. But I don't find. Material. Mano Goswami Maharaj asking secretly to Prabhupada, you can remember me, I can discuss this point. What is the advice of Prabhupada and what question was put by Mano Goswami Maharaj? I can discuss, you can remember. I can discuss this one. Then you can understand Prabhupada is not against Rupanuga Bhakti. Prabhupada is 100% in favor of, 100% in Nayanmani Manjari. 100% he likes to speak all the secrecies of this bhajan. But it's very secret point. But Prabhupada expressed it. That is why I came on this material planet. But I don't find any place where to speak, whom to speak. Now my time is over. Now I am going to leave this material world. Prabhupada speaking. Direct speech, Prabhupada, directly speaking, Bhakti Siddhanta. I am not changing even a single syllable, single word. I am not changing, same thing I'm speaking. So now you follow? When I speak this point, they fight with me, you are against Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami. How? But my Guru Maharaj approved Jamkirtan, you are not in. I said, no, man, come on. I am not speaking that you should not do. But I put condition, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Elila Chintar Karo Sankirtan. You cannot do Sankirtan perfectly. But that is why you have no right to do. When Bhaktivinoda Madhava Goswami Maharaj, our Guru Maharaj, present in front of me, if they order me, they can give some power. Hey, you do this Jamkirtan. That's mean I have no danger because they are standing in front of me. They are controlling me, my mind. And that time also. Like Parikshit Maharaj have no right to go through Rasalila. But how we find that Parikshit Maharaj hearing Rasalila? Because Sukhdev Goswami giving big power to Parikshit Maharaj. To hear Rasalila. Even after that, by the mercy of Krishna, Parikshit Maharaj putting so many questions, doubts. Otherwise we cannot cut the doubts. So man, I can discuss this point. So I understand. I am not against Jamakirtan. I am not against Rasatattva, nothing. People misunderstand. Many people speaking this way, our Gurudev Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami never speak that way. Why you are speaking that way? The way of representation can be different. Same thing, Kesava Goswami Maharaj speak. Our Guru Maharaj speaking same thing, representation different. So why you fight on this point? Representation, the way of representation maybe. Just a few minutes before I was discussing. You can develop big scholarship, but that is what is concerned to us. If you can understand this point, is good. So I am against Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami. They are in favor of Gurudev. They can prove. Let them come in front of me. They can prove. They are in favor of Gurudev. If you shout Gurudev Vadaya Karo Gurudev, that means I am in favor of Gurudev. There is one kind of Guruvad, Guruism. It is one kind of Guruvad. Guruvad, no? They like Mayavad, Guruvad, Guruism. Is also foolishness. Guruism. This how Guru, Guru, Guru. You must understand Guru and Vaishnava are the same. Why you cannot understand? Why you think these bodies are my Gurudev? Why you think? You are so foolish. You cannot, why you cannot understand this point? Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva also they cannot understand. Our Gurudev, your Gurudev? Our Gurudev? It is my Gurudev, it is your Gurudev, why? They are fighting among themselves. It is Guruva, Guruism, it is not Guru Bhakti. If there is Guru Bhakti, I am in Vyasasana, I am sitting. If there is Guru Bhakti, 100% you should have Bhakti for Vaishnava. Otherwise there is false Guru Bhakti. Negative Guru Bhakti. 100%. If you have Guru Bhakti, then you must have Vaishnava Bhakti also. You must honor Vaishnava. One sloka, many times I discuss this point. By Jiva Goswami Pada. By Jiva Goswami Pada, this sloka in Sandarbha. Gurubhag Gaya, Tat Sevan Aviradena Sha, Annesha Mopi Vaishnavanam Sevanam Sreya. Gurubhag Gaya, by the permission of Gurupad Padma, if there is no hamper, I mean, if there is no problem with my Guru Seva, with the permission of Guru Maharaj, I can serve all other pure Vaishnava. Jiva Goswami Pada speak. Guru Bhag Gaya, by the order of Guru Pad Padma, suppose by the order of Guru Pad Padma, if I like to serve Guru Vaishnava, and if I serve Guru Vaishnava, if there is no danger of my Guru Seva itself, then there is no problem. I mean, you should reconcile Vaishnava Tattva and Guru Tattva, you must understand. Understand my fault. My Guru Maharaj give me order to serve Bhakti Vallabhi Tugasim Maharaj. So I serve. If I say he is Bhakti Vallabhi Tugasim Maharaj, he is not my Guru Varga, it's not good. My Guru Maharaj giving order. Go and serve him. Then there is no danger with my Guru Seva. It is also Guru Seva. To execute the order of Gurudev is Guru Seva. Many times I told, when in Vrindavan Leela you find Krishna messaging the leg of Balaram. Now people asking, Krishna giving a nice service to Balaram. I say, no, your darshan is wrong. Balaram is serving Krishna. Huh? Krishna serving Balaram. You are wrong. But what do you mean by seva? Seva means satisfaction to whom I am serving. Balaram taking service from Krishna only for this reason, that Krishna becomes satisfied. So it is a seva of Krishna. Maybe Krishna is messaging the leg of Balaram. But it is actually a seva of Krishna. Very top secret. Nobody can understand. So Bhakti Vallabhi Tugasim Maharaj is you cannot understand his activities, you cannot understand Siddhanta, very secret. So very sorry. They are fighting. I always giving, different kind of argument they are putting in front of me. I am giving answer. Even in writing, Prasad Prabhu, 1 year, almost eight months or 1 year back, he ring me, he speaking, you must write two articles. One about your relation with Bhakti Vallabhi Tugasim Maharaj, and about some Siddhanta, secret. I already give. I don't know, they publish in internet or not. You must ask this question to Prasad Prabhu, I like to talk. Can you arrange my meeting? I like to talk with Prasad. I have, because my time is very limited. I love so much time, so much my seva. I cannot do. So now I like to stop. And if time permit, next Akshaya Tritiya day, I am going to Assam. So, Akshaya Tritiya, if I can, five times should be very punctual. Otherwise, that day I am very busy, all day. Then I will have to go to Assam, that day same. So, I am busy. Akshaya Tritiya day, you are going to stay?
Tomorrow? I'm probably going to Kolkata. Either today or tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Today or tomorrow.
Day after tomorrow.
Today or tomorrow.
Day after today or tomorrow.
Today or tomorrow.
Achha, then I am not sure actually I will have to stop. Vancha Kalpatarvashya ke Pasindhi Babaji Patitanam Pavana Bhavishna Bhyonam. Okay, nice. If you have any doubt, then you can put question. Then, Sono, you must put question in front of Prasad Prabhu. Two articles written by Maharaj. You told you can publish in internet and in paper also. I think they are going to publish one magazine also. If you, if they can publish it kindly, at least they cannot misunderstand you. Not all, a few devotees, they are envious with me. Because automatically Krishna giving me pratishtha. Automatically Krishna, I don't like your pratishtha. Don't give me pratishtha. Still automatically pratishtha coming to me. You know the way of my lifestyle. So they are envious. So what to do? Then I will have to throw everything and go to solitary bhajan. It's not good. That is why. So a few devotees. Not all, a few devotees. Bharati Maharaj already knew this point. That time Bharati Maharaj was there in Chandigarh. I was 1 month and 5 days speaking Bhagavad Katha in Hindi. In where? In Bhatinda. Instantly that message went to over phone. Sam, Maharaj, do you think we can speak Bindadevi Mataji? Bharati Maharaj speak, Bharati Maharaj is very clever. Bharati Maharaj, see, in my life I never speak that way. Only speak this point. And I heard from one disciple of Tila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj, old devotee, is Pujari of Bhatinda. He told Maharaj, in my own life I never heard Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj singing this song. Namore Namore Mai. That devotee is there in Bhatinda. You can go and ask him. He told, in my whole life I never hear Bhakti Vidya Madhava Goswami never doing this song. But now we are here. But Bhakti Vallabha Goswami is very, very exalted sadhu. We cannot understand it more. We can misinterpret him. Oh, Maharaj is not speaking this way. Maharaj, it's not good. We must understand. At least if you can understand and come to me or come to any pure devotees, I am not pure devotee. Okay, you can. Okay, don't worry.
Maharaj, one question.
What question?
Yes.
Hani aste rakho rakho. Ekhane part ache rakho rakho.
Ase ki thakur ke do. Lago Bhagat Amrita Shri Rupa Goswami that is saying this. Gaman and agaman is coming and going. Like, and I was thinking because I heard that the Nitya Lila and the Prakat Lila. Or here this Prakat Lila is shown some parts of the Nitya Lila.
Yes.
It's a mixture.
Yes. Mixture. Like Tuma, like Kaṃsa is not there in transcendental. Yeah. It's
or
mixture.
Like, or like Balya Leela, it's coming and then disappearing. Then the next Kaishore.
Yes.
Sometimes. Is it the same with the pure Vaishnava? Is he also?
Actually, how you can think? If you think Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Mahaprabhu dying is good, Nitya Leela.
No.
They are also coming and going, but then each their lila, I mean Bala lila, Kaushal lila, all little. You'll have to think that way. Otherwise, material conception.
Coming and going.
Yes. Otherwise, material conception can come. Because Krishna and his all paraphernalia are all eternal. It is written in Krishna.
That is going to another universe.
Yes. Nitayer charan satya tahara sevak nitto. My Siddhanta I prove from Kirtan by Narottam Thakur. Nitai Charan Satya, the lotus feet of Nitai is Nitya, and he is all Sevak the Nitya. Then what does it mean? Nitai Charan Satya, Tahara Sevak Nitya. What does it mean? You explain? Explain thing. So, Abhimanyu, I am going, eh?